Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the Bal poem by John Berryman. First, we see about the poet. John Berryman was an American poet and scholar. He was born on 25th October 1914 in Alstair, Ocla, in the United States of America. He was married to Kat Dunnock in 1961. He was educated at Clare College, Columbia University. The Dream Songs, Songs 77 Dream Songs and Berryman's Shakespeare are some of his famous works. Now we'll see the poem. First stanza, what is the boy now who has lost his ball? What is he to do? I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over there it is in the water. In this stanza, the poet sees a boy playing with the ball. Then the boy loses his ball. The poet asks, what should the boy be feeling now? He asks, what will the boy do now? He saw the ball bouncing merrily and going down the street. And now, in the same way, it has fallen into the water and lost forever. Here, bouncing means jumping over. Street means narrow path. Merrily means very happily. Then the second stanza, no use to say, oh, there are other balls. An ultimate shaking grip fixes the boy as he stands rigid, trembling, staring down all his young days into the harbor where his ball went. There is no use of consoling the boy. He can't be consoled if he is offered other balls in place of the last ball. Finally, a deep grief overpowers the boy. He stands shaking there without leaving the place. Standing there, he stares down the place where the ball has disappeared in the water of the harbor. The loss of the ball in the harbor reminds him of his childhood and childhood days which have been lost in the harbor of life. Here, ultimate means final. Shaking means trembling. Grief means sorrow. Staring means looking keenly. Then third stanza, I would not intrude on him a dime. Another ball is worthless. Now he senses first responsibility in a world of possessions. The poet does not want to intervene or console the boy. He will not tell the boy that the ball he has lost cost almost nothing. He will not console him by saying that he can buy another ball quite easily. Now good sense prevails over the boy. He knows that in this world people are always running after acquiring and owning things. He realizes what is his first responsibility in such a world. Intrude means encroach. A dame means very cheap. Worthless means useless. Responsibility means sense of duty. World of possessions means world where people are busy in possessing things. Then the next stanza, people will take balls. Balls will be lost always, little boy. And no one buys a ball back. Money is external. Buying and losing continues throughout our life. People will always buy such balls, and the balls they buy will continue to be lost. Once a ball has been lost, it is last ball again. Money is totally external to our inner feelings. Money can't compensate our emotional losses. Similarly, the childhood that we have lost forever can't be bought back with money. Here, the word external means outwardly or not internal. That is called external. The childhood that we have lost forever can't be bought back with the money. Then the last stanza. He is learning well behind his desperate eyes. This epistemology of loss, how to stand up, knowing what every man must one day know, and most know many days how to stand up. The boy with his hopeless eyes is beginning to learn the nature of loss. He is learning what it means to lose something. He has to learn how to come over the loss and stand up again in life. He has to learn this basic principle of life, which every man of the world has to learn. He must learn how to bear the pangs of the loss of his childhood. He has to move ahead in life, forgetting the loss of his childhood. Here, desperate means hopeless. Epistemology means knowledge. Epistemology of loss means understanding the nature of loss. Behind means backward. Okay, now we will see the main points of this poem. The young boy lost his ball. He was playing and saw the ball bouncing down the street. Then, in the end, the ball fell down into the water and lost forever. The boy sees everything happening before his eyes, but he is helpless. He only stands there helplessly, mourning at the loss of the ball. The loss of the ball may appear to be an ordinary incident. It seems that boys lost such balls many times while they are playing. The boy should not make a fuss over it. The loss of ball is symbolic. It has a deeper meaning in this poem. The next, the loss of the ball is the loss of childhood and the loss of his dreams. And if it is lost, it never comes back again. Similarly, we can't console the child that he can have another ball. Actually, he is sad that the ball he has lost can't be brought back. The innocent childhood that he has lost can't be replaced or bought back with money. Wealth can't buy life and time. Ultimately, a change comes in the grieving boy. He comes to know that Losing is a part of life. Then the loss must not break his spirits. The loss must not break his spirits. There is no use of grieving over what has been lost. He must stand up to face such losses with courage and determination. Life has to be lived and not wasted in grieving and mourning over the losses suffered in the past. Okay, then students, today's homework is answer the short answers questions. Thank you, students.